Hiya, welcome in the Hungarian Nomads YouTube channel. Today is going to be our newest adventure when we are going to Tulum for a day trip. So Tulum is approximately 130 kilometers south from Cancun. You can get there by taking the bus, that's what we're going to take, but also there are some organized group programs if you'd like to join those. But we more like the experience ourselves kind of people. So we're going to take the bus, it's called ADO, ADO. The tickets are approximately £30 for two people in the round trip. We are going early in the morning and then we're going to come back by late night, late afternoon, we can say, and we're gonna discover Tulum for ourselves. If you're interested in another city which is famous for its Mayan ruins, and this is the only Mayan ruins that's standing by the ocean, come and join us and we'll show it to you. Tulum. It took us like 3 hours to get here from Cancun city center from the bus station. Like I said, the tickets were super cheap and the service was on point. It's better than any other European services that I've seen before, so it's a really comfy bus with aircon and everything. And then we get to Tulum in like 3 hours. It took us 3 hours because it stopped for other places, not just, you know, a straight right here. The admission fee is around £30 each, so it's 80 pesos per person. Make sure that you bring the exact amount because most of the time they are not able to bring back any money. So try to bring the exact amount. And if you want to take photos or videos like we do, you also need to pay 50 pesos of like a tax for making films and videos, so just be prepared that you need to pay for that as well. Otherwise, the other rules that you need to wear the mask, even if it's an outside area, you will need to keep the mask on all the time at the minute. So as soon as you get off from the bus, be prepared that they're gonna attack you with all their offers. But if you don't want to pay, you know, big prices and you don't want the private tour, you just want to walk by yourself, that's the cheapest way to do this whole tour. So let's go and see the ruins. From any other ruined cities that you can find in the Yucatan, because it's in the seaside, as you can see behind me. So it was one of the most important trade hubs for the obsidian, which was super wealthy pleasure back in the time. Also, what you need to know about Tulum, it's a walled fortress. Actually, Tulum, the word itself means wall. But to be fair, way before the Mayan culture, there was already life here. And also back in the time, its name was Zama, which means the city of the dawn, because straight there that you can see now, it's the sunrise spot on Earth. So it means the city of the dawn. The city itself was first mentioned by the Spanish conquestors in 1518. So back in the time. But to be fair, the city's history is going way, way back. So last year in 2020, there was an archaeological expedition and the archaeologists found an almost 10,000 years old female body underwater. So they find the skeleton here, it was a female body around the 30s. So that's an exact proof that there was life way before the Mayans came here and built this fortress, Tulum, but the area itself was habitat way before. In Tulum, the three main buildings, the architectural building that you can still see, the main three ruins are the El Castillo, which means the castle, the Temple of the Frescoes, which is unique because with the frescoes on the walls, they could track the, you know, the movement of the sun, that's how they track time back in the days. And the last place is the Temple of the Descending God. So we're gonna see this and we're gonna show it to you. We could walk across the Tulum Mayan ruins. It was an amazing experience. We really suggest it for anyone. But be prepared, there's many tourists there. They're super annoying. They stop in every second. There's barely any chance to check anything out properly. But you know, if you calm down, take a deep breath, then you can have a look around. I think in like an hour and a half, you can walk the whole thing across, but as you can see, it's gonna be a bit sweaty. So we really suggest to bring some water with you, as well as food if you don't want to spend a lot on these things. And because all that, we think we deserve some sun and some sea now. So we're gonna have a jump into the Caribbean scene right now. Thanks for joining us today and see you next time in the next video.